Based on purchase amount and credit, sir. So these are the table of content. So basically what we need to do is we have a data set based on the e-commerce website and that contains the product ID, user ID, the product, the user information like gender, age and everything, and the product categories they have. So we need to basically predict the amount based on that features like product, like I mentioned. So purchase amount, what will the amount will be the for particular user or particular product, what? So we need to predict the amount for every user, that how much he will he or she will spend on product.
We have a historical data set of how much they have purchased previously. So using that we would train a model
and
predict. I'm logged into your e-commerce website. So this tool will predict what is the amount that I'm
for a particular product. So for a particular product, what would be your purchasing capacity? You can say amount or capacity in both the same sense. Like for if a user is X and what is its purchasing power for electronics. So if he has like more in electronic sections, then he would be shown products that are more electronic. So it, the application of this project would be on that targeted advertising activity.
Okay,
so
for whom this application is helped?
It would help for the e-commerce website.
Right. So that they can provide more offers to the particular
user. Based on the user
data. Based on the user data.
So if capacity, you will filter those and you will show
So that was our application based on the model that we created.
And what was the amount of the user to purchase some items on particular products?
In which category they purchase more, so that a particular user can get the offer for that particular product.
So we have read two main research paper for this product project. First was the machine learning framework for prediction purchase by online customer based on dynamic pricing. In that research paper, we found that the particular author of that, they create one application on that for e-commerce website. On that customer and the market going on, and that base means as an example that if electronics marketing has rising so much, so that e-commerce owners or employments are going to give less amount or some discount on the particular electronics offer, so that their customers easily spend on that amount and buy some products on that, so they can easily, and if the purchase amount, if the product segment goes less popular, so that they can buy less and they give the price low. So in that they use supervised machine learning and give the example that we have answered that on that basis, that amount and the purchase which previously buys. So in the second one we search that mobile application about games, that in that research paper they get the customer data on the basis of the customer who install the free games and buy elements of in that paid elements in that game in from the games, like in nowadays PUBG is more popular and they given more elements and more items by purchasing it. So how customers spent on amount of money on the paid elements. So in that they have used neural network and XgBoost. So we have to analyze that, and we also applied in our project to analyze how the prediction going on. And
these are the tools and technologies.
And we have the Python 3 is the open source technology tool, so we have to use it. Sklearn library is inbuilt library in Python, inbuilt library for machine learning models, so we can easily use it. And Google TensorFlow for graph, for graphing or animation related information, showing information. And the Keras is the neural network which will be, which would be used in the our project. And Jupyter notebook for some, like directly get output for some it. And the C1 for also some graph above for graph. And the Flask for deployments on the website. So
first we start with the data exploration. Like we need to see that how data is, how is the data, and what are the features which are relevant or not relevant, which are which has the missing value. We need to explore the data set. Then we visualize the data that how the data is like how many user ID, how many product, and how they differ from the for each features and everything. So after then we pre-process the data. We first for missing data we used mean for those features who has a missing value. Then we generate the model. We used two model to compare that how much our is both model is being performed. So we used XgBoost and a neural network. So and then we have tested the application and deploy on the Flask.
So as you can see, this part is the head of the dataset, the sample dataset, which would have user ID, product ID, gender, age, occupation, city category, and at the end would be the purchase amount that the user made for a particular product. So what information is we have is that for a user X, he has made a purchase of 8,000 under product category this, and for which product. So we have this data. Now as you can see in product category,
8,000 for the duration of how many days?
It was
data set
for we have assumed that it was for a year. The data set where it was uploaded, they haven't mentioned by how much span they have collected
the
data.
From
IBM, they provided us the data set.
Don't have data points like this particular item, this date it was purchased.
Timestamp was not available.
So what kind of data you have? This is what it you have.
This is what we said. Yeah. So for a user, it has multiple rows. So what we use is that aggregated.
For each product ID
that he has purchased. Huh. So as you can see, product category 2 and 3 has missing values. So they both basically had. This much amount of missing values, 117,000 for this. So now, then we replace those missing values using the mean of that column. And then the new cleaner data set was generated from it. Then basically we have the range of the values that we have. For gender it is female or male, for age it is, the range is like 0 to 17, 18 to 25. Occupation, these are number of categories, city categories. So this is the basic visualization of all the values. And this is the user ID versus product ID. Then we split the training and training and testing data set.
What is the percentage you are using for testing amount?
70-30.
So in the first we have decided the to baseline performance model, and after that which model we use, that the error should be less than that base model. So in the base model, we generate the mean of the whole purchase amount of all the users, and after that we getting mean, and we after getting the mean value, we minus the value of the user ID. If the mean value is higher than the amount which of user which will be purchased, that so in that the it goes to in minus. So and after if the mean value is less than the purchase amount of the customer, then it will be in the plus. So we have to add it in that, and we decide that the what is the base line, what was the error of that, what was the error of that amount. So baseline performance model gives the amount of like 5,023.06% amount of error.
So we use
5,000 units. So it was not specified whether the purchase was in dollar or rupees. So we kept it. So it might be any currency that you can.
We used our root mean square error to perform our regression model. That so we basically perform the baseline, and on that value we consider that if the if our model comes to the higher value than this, then the model should not be used for our prediction. So we used XgBoost first, and we get 2976 RMSE. So we used some by default parameters for XgBoost. Then we change some of the parameters and get this value, and we deploy this XgBoost using Flask. So we used XgBoost and neural network and comparison. We get a lesser amount in XgBoost. So we use. The comparison for RMSE value.
There are actually two outcomes of the model that we used. So our model was basically to predict the purchase amount. So that doesn't give much output to a e-commerce website. So we thought, how can we use this output and create an application out of it? So what we did is, for a given particular product, we predicted the purchase amount for all the users. So for a given product, let's say electronics, what would be the purchasing power for each user? Then we gave top 10 users or top 5 users for that. So if
based on top users and based on
that amount
purchase amount. So the max purchase amount would be the higher. So the top users that would have the maximum purchase within that segment would be shown. So then the e-commerce website can cater to those customers and give targeted advertisement and everything. And reverse of that would be, for a particular user, what is the top categories that the user purchases it in. So for a given user, he has to show some ads or anything, he can use this data as well. So we have two applications like that. We have a demo.
Both the applications are
good. Yeah. User IDs would be shown. And the e-commerce website would have a lookup from ID to username. So it would use this top user ID for a given particular product. Now we have entered user ID.
top category will be shown.
And the top categories in which the user has made the purchase will be shown. Like the category number 4 is the highest. So we didn't have the lookup of which category is which in the dataset. So we have category ID 4. The e-commerce website would have some dictionary to map it.